Hello everyone, I am Janapati Srinu. Who are watching first time my video, subscribe my channel and share to your friends. I came here to explain about CSIR examination preparation, especially for chemical sciences. And also, I am going to explain strategy of the chemical science paper, right? So, chemical science paper. So, in chemical science, we have the inorganic, organic, physical and analytical, right? Physical and analytical subjects are, specializations are there. Analytical subject, right? Analytical. So, actually most of the questions they will ask from the inorganic, organic, physical chemistry, right? So, first I am going to explain the examination pattern, right? So, in this examination, we have the three parts, part A first, then part B, then part C. Part C, right? In part A, so aptitude questions, general aptitude questions, they will give 20 questions, right? From these 20 questions, we have to do only 15 questions, right? So 15 questions. 15 into 2 marks, total 30 marks. 5 questions is choice, right? In part B, they will provide 40 questions, right? 40 questions. We have to do only 35 questions. 35 2 into 2 is 70. In part C, they will give 60 questions, right? 60 questions. From this, we have to do only 25 questions. 25 into 4 is 100 marks. Total 30 plus 70 plus 100. Total maximum marks of the exam is 200 marks. 200 marks, right? And in this exam, we have the negative marking. Negative marking means 1 by 4th negative marking, right? 1 by 4th negative means out of the 2 marks each question, so how many marks are negative? If question is 2 marks, so how many of the negative marks will cut off from this 2? So 4 parts means if you will do, so that is 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. So for this questions, negative is 0.5. If you mark the answer, that is negative, that means wrong answer, so you will minus 0.5 you will get. So from this also 2 marks means, into 2 marks questions means, see you will get minus, if each wrong answer you will get the minus 0.5 the negative marking. So for this is the 4 marks questions, so if you mistake the question, if it is the wrong, so you will get the 1 mark. Out of 4 marks means 1 part is 1 mark, 1 by 4 is 1, right? So you will get the minus 1 negative marking, right? Many of the peoples will get doubt. So what is that? If you will do more than, for example, in this 20 questions we have to do, right? That is 25 questions if it is. So generally, if you will do the 30 questions, right? The system won't accept. System will accept only up to 25 questions. 25 questions only. After 25 answers, if you want to keep, so it will not take. So that means you have to do only maximum 25 questions. What are the correct? That only you keep. Okay. So from this 200, for generally, don't bother about cutoff, right? So in the choice also, you will get the 200 maximum marks. In the maximum 200 marks, if you will get, for example, 100 plus, that may be 100 to 110, maximum 110. The cutoff decides for JRF or NET, JRF or NET for OBC general. So maximum, so chances are there, maximum cutoff is mostly, the cutoff is varies between 100 and 110, between the 100 and 110. If you got some good marks, you will get the JRF. So that means, if you reach the maximum JRF cutoff, you will get the JRF. So if you will for NET cutoff, that maybe you can get NET. Who are qualified JRF? So that means they are both eligible for JRF plus NET. So this is the one more doubt I am going to clear. Next, I am going to discuss about examination strategy, right? So preparation strategy. Strategy, right? So in this, mainly you should focus on the part C, right? Part C, out of 60 questions, right? 60 questions, 20 from inorganic, 20 from organic, 20 from the physical. 20 from physical, right? So who are specialization have in their MSc, who are very well in the any of two subjects is enough. So that means if you are thoroughly practiced inorganic and organic, so that is okay. So you should just to focus on the physical, which are the important topics. So that will covers extra good marks for you. So from this 40 marks, 40 questions, you can select any 20-25 questions easily, right? So from the, if you, for the physical support, you can take some 4 to 5 questions from this. We can keep from this only, you can keep 20 plus 5, 25 like this. That means what is my intention is, if you thoroughly practiced in any two sessions very very perfect, that we can crack the CSIR net. You can crack easily CSIR JRF net, right? So now I am going to discuss about examination strategy. Inorganic, right? So inorganic is a very fundamental concepts we have to prepare. So main area is coordination chemistry. Coordination chemistry. Then next we have to prepare OMC, right? Reaction mechanism, coordination chemistry, reaction mechanism, OMC complete topic you have to prepare, right? OMC, then first group, second group elements, that means all periodic properties. So these periodic properties, all some properties are useful in the 2 months. Periodic properties you should prepare, and D block and F block, very very important. Most of the times they will ask from this D and F block, mostly compulsory. You will get 4 to 6 marks from the D and F block. So you should prepare. My intention is to prepare mainly focus on the coordination, OMC and periodic properties, D and F block and non-aqueous solvents and acid base, bio-inorganic. The core area is bio-inorganic you should prepare. So that is very good covering topic for CSIR inorganic concepts. Metalloenzymes you should prepare. So first you should focus on this. So you will get most of the questions from coordination, OMC only. And bio-inorganic complete compulsory, mostly you will get either 6 to 10 marks you will get from the bio-inorganic. So this is about inorganic. The best books you have to prepare, and group theory, symmetry. You can also cover symmetry, group theory, right? Group theory. So for symmetry and group theory, you can follow the Veera Reddy. K. Veera Reddy book is very good for symmetry and group theory concept. And coordination and reaction mechanism, Gopalan Ramalingam book is very good. And for aqueous, non-aqueous solvents and bio-inorganic, all those you can prepare the Huhi. So that means you have to prepare Veera Reddy and Huhi book, so and Gopalan Ramalingam book. And for OMC you can also follow the Michler and Tarr. Some advanced concepts are there in the Catherine Housecraft, right? So you can read some basic books, you will get the complete knowledge of this topic. Ajay Kumar is also very good for coordination chemistry. You can follow either that is. So for organic, so you should focus on the oxidation, reduction, OMC, right? And stereochemistry, these are the core area. Mostly they will ask oxidation, reduction and OMC. Reagents they will ask, you can say simply reagents, right? Stereochemistry and heterocyclics. You can prepare for carbohydrates and amino acids. These for some times they will ask, focus on the 2 marks question. Most of the books already we know that book is Claydon book, and Carother you can also follow. So these are the good books we can say for organic chemistry. So if I talk about physical chemistry, right? If I talk about physical chemistry, we have to mainly focus on the electrochemistry, thermodynamics, chemical kinetics. CK means chemical kinetics, and quantum, right? So in electrochemistry, along with this electrochemistry, you have there in 1, 2, 3 parts are there, right? So the best book is Puri Sharma Patania. Puri Sharma Patania. Puri Sharma Patania. And KL Kapoor is also KL Kapoor. For molecular spectra, Bunwell is the best book. Bunwell, right? Follow the Bunwell. So different books are there. Puri Sharma Patania is almost covers most of the topics in this. Next, in this 1 and 2, you have to also prepare for acid base concept and chemical equilibria, ionic equilibria. If you will prepare entire, you should prepare at one place only, so that is you can read easily. So in the thermodynamics, you can read the gaseous state. Next, statistical thermodynamics, all are at one place, that is very easy to cover everything. You can divide the sessions wise. So that is electrochemistry, thermodynamics. In chemical kinetics, we can follow the chemical kinetics, enzyme catalysis, compulsory question. Most times they will ask enzyme catalysis and solid state. Enzyme catalysis, then photochemistry, then surface chemistry and polymers. If you completely divide this chapter, is that is as one part. In quantum chemistry, we can follow the R.K. Prasad book, is good for you. R.K. Prasad, some concepts, approach is there, problems approach, quantum chemistry, atomic structure, advanced level, you should prepare for quantum, right? So mostly, almost all these topics are covered in the Puri Sharma Patania. You should focus on main core areas of enzyme catalysis, surface. These are the must following topics. Polymers, statistical thermodynamics is most of the times they are focusing on this. And one more thing is remaining topics, solid state, phase rule. You can finish in this thermodynamics only. Phase rule. So what are the topics there? You should prepare very well. So these are the preparation strategy of inorganic, organic, physical, right? These are the questions. Mostly they will focus on these areas only. You should study the most previous questions only. They will mostly focus. So you should know the approach. Previous questions you should follow. Revise. If you revise many times, it will be automatically memorized in your mind, right? So by reading all those materials, different materials, so at one time, so by preparing only one book many times is very good, my opinion. As I am cracking, already I cracked CSIR JRF net, so my sincere suggestion is, so first keep some reference books, so every time you should follow that only, so that will be more very helpful to crack the CSIR net examinations. So all the very best to the next CSIR January 2022 examinations. Thank you very much. Subscribe my channel and share to your friends.